So, Jeevi, we did some homework, and Varsha has, you know, she's been working with this company called Tech Enterprises, mid-sized IT company, which provides digital solutions in various domains.
Okay.
And so Varsha has some interesting problems that she would like us to look at. What I thought I'll do is give a very quick overview of this company, and then I'm going to request Varsha to tell us a little bit more about what are the some of the challenges that this company is facing. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
So it's about a 15-16-year-old company, 3,500 employees, and as an IT company goes, that's not a small company, but it's not a very large company either, right? So some of our larger companies would have more than 100,000 employees. Now, one very important, so there are many websites that when we're looking at recruitment, there are many websites which help a prospective employee get a better understanding of the company. One such website is Glassdoor. There are many such, but in this particular case, this company has a Glassdoor rating of 3.515.
Is it good or bad? What does it mean?
It's, I would say it's average. Varsha, what do you think?
Yeah, it's average. So this is based on employees' perception, right? So if I'm working with a certain organization, I'll go to either a Glassdoor. It's like, you know, any of those review sites, and I will give a rating for various factors. How good is the organization? Do I get some kind of growth? Do I get some kind of learning? You know, how, and there is also, if I'm not mistaken, a rating for the CEO. So the leader is the most important part in an organization. What is the CEO rating? A 3.5 is an okay rating. Anything below 3 would want to just check whether, you know, there's something wrong with the organization. Does it meet our requirements or not? And 4 and above would be considered fairly good.
Okay. All right. It's good.
And then this company seems to have, attrition rate. So Varsha, what is attrition rate?
So if you have 100 employees, for example, Milind, in your organization, and this is for the whole year, from April 2020 to March 2021, say 18 of those people go away, right? That is called attrition rate.
It's a lot of people, 18
or 100. In IT services, GVM Milan, what we have seen for the last 20 years, we've always had these kind of attrition rates, especially in IT services companies. It's around 18%. In some of the other sectors, so if you look at manufacturing sector, your attrition percentage out there would be in the single digits, anywhere between 5% to 9%. But in IT specifically, this is what we see. In pharma sector also, we see a higher level of attrition, but typically not at 18%. That's also between 12% and 15%. Okay. IT in India has, you know, the highest number of people walking out of the door for an organization.
So intuitively, it seems to me, Varsha, is that if employees have more options, more companies that they can go and work for, then attrition rate will be higher. Is that correct?
No. So there are a lot of opportunities in the other sector also. One of the aspects that we have seen in IT services is that people find it's easier to set their own employment contracts in terms of, you know, what is the kind of project that you can get onto? What is the kind of learning that you will get? And this is really what kind of incentivizes people to look for opportunities outside. Yes, to a certain extent, it is helped by the fact that there are more roles that are available, but there is also a certain push factor from the individual itself saying that, you know, I want to go on-site or I want to have an exposure to full stack development. Those are the kind of things that actually push a person into looking for roles outside their organization.
Interesting. So people have a view of how their career should develop, is it?
Exactly. Yes, that's right.
I see. That's very interesting.
Shall we look at the case? What are the problems?
Yeah. So, Varsha, you want to walk us through?
Yeah, sure. So as you can see, the attrition percentage we just discussed, right? It was 18% for tech enterprises, very normal for the industry. When you look at that, what you must remember is that you're basically hiring one out of every five employees that you have every year. Now, in this kind of a situation, some of the key players that we see in, you know, for tech enterprises would be one, the person who's actually managing the programs. So if I know that I have a team of 50 people and I know that I'm going to have to replace 10 people in that over the next year, me as a program manager, it's very important that I know who are the kind of people that we are hiring. So I have a budget to match. I have to make sure that I give my my business head the kind of profitability that is required. So the first person that we have in this whole drama is Madhuri, who's a program manager in Tech Enterprises. She is responsible for delivering solutions to her clients, and she has a team that works with her. Only from a recruitment perspective, and we're just looking at that particular aspect out here, the second person who plays an equally important role would be Ritesh, who actually looks at recruitment. He is actually part of the HR team. He would end up reporting to a HR head in Tech Enterprises. But functionally, he will work with Madhuri and report to Vidya, because he's basically hiring. He's making sure that all the vacancies that Madhuri has in her team are hired for and are fulfilled.
So Varsha, there is one person who's full-time looking at recruitment, is it?
So in a company of 3,500, typically you will have a recruitment team of about anywhere between 3 to 7 people, right? So wow. Larger organizations, which have got, you know, whether it's a TCS, Wipro, Infosys, they'll have larger teams consisting of 100, 200 people who are just looking at recruitment. And when I say recruitment, it's basically around making sure that there are positions and there are people. So they might not all be on roles, but, you know, they might have outsourced some of the work, making sure interviews are scheduled, candidate profiles are received. So it's fairly in work intensive or effort intensive to find a role or to find a candidate who's best suited for your positions. Last but not the least, we have Vidya, who is responsible for taking decisions, and she's head of the business in a sense. We've just called her vice president Tech Enterprises, who doesn't play that big a role, but definitely is involved in taking decisions on who needs to get hired in this particular case, right? So we'll start off very simple. We'll start off very small. And we will go to the first case or the first caselet, one example of the kind of problems that Madhuri and Ritesh typically have to deal with. A little bit of background about Madhuri is that, as we saw, Tech Enterprises was set up in 2005, and she has been with Tech Enterprises right off campus. She was hired as a fresher, and she has grown through the ranks to become a project director, program manager in about 13 years. She has a team of 55 employees. And therefore, as I said, you know, she ends up having to hire at least 10 people in a year just to maintain the team at 55 employees. So she comes across this very usual problem that most program managers have to deal with. She has been hiring at least, 10 to 15 people right out of the campus. One of them who has been with Madhuri post his graduation as an engineer, he has decided that he's going to go do, further education. He's interested in doing a master's abroad, and therefore he's resigned. He's serving his notice period. His last day is going to be on 31st May, right? And Madhuri realizes that she really needs a replacement for Abhi because he's part of one of the most important projects that is being delivered. So the person that she would reach out to would be the recruitment head in the organization, who's Ritesh, and tell him that I need a replacement for Abhi. So this is where we have, these are the broad problems for the first case, saying that Madhuri desperately needs a replacement. It's pretty much life as usual, but this is a problem. She needs a replacement. Abhi, who she has trained and groomed over the last 5 years, is now quitting the organization.
So presumably the replacement will come at the same salary as the existing comment.
The replacement should typically come at the same salary or a slightly lower salary. Yeah, and also with somebody with, you know, a similar experience, similar profile.
Yeah.
So that's what Madhuri would look for. Because and costs otherwise would run away.
Abhi's profile and all is in the database. So we know exactly what we know.
Exactly.
He has to provide it.
Abhi's profile would be in the HR ERP system. It would have things like, when, you know, how many years of experience he has, what are the competencies, what are the skills that he has, as well as what has been his performance ratings for the last 3 or 5 years, and what is the salary that he gets currently, fixed as well as variable pay.